Good evening. Welcome to the CIU Ambassador Choir Christmas concert. This is part of our Christmas at CIU weekend. We've already been loving it. We have a great musical, a little bit of a musical happening with a festive troupe here. This evening, our goal is to lead you and your mind and your heart into Advent and the culmination of Christmas and God's chosen interaction with us through His Son, Jesus. We hope that, that it will fill you with joy and anticipation for that day as we enter into Advent in our church season. This is also the kickoff for this choir for our Christmas tour. This choir, right after finals and graduation, takes off and heads north, and we'll be touring for a week doing very similar presentation, depending on the staff. So we're going to open up in prayer for you and for us, and also for that tour. My name is Bryce Thompson. I am the director of this ensemble, and I'm a very lucky person to be so. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this opportunity to gather in your name. And God, I pray that as we present to you, as we speak about you, as we sing music that was written for you, whether it be in the last few years or centuries ago, Lord, we pray that, that you will be glorified and that you will be what we fix our eyes on this evening. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Once you hear words of a cheer from everywhere, Philly. all the land. Hey, do you have time for a story? It's one of my favorites. Delighted. What? A book of rules, you say? No, the Bible isn't a book of rules. It's an adventure story of a young hero who comes from a far country to win back his lost treasure. It's a love story about a brave prince who leaves his palace, his throne, everything, to rescue the one he loves. It's like the most wonderful fairy tale that has come true in real life. You see, the best thing about this story is it's true. There are lots of stories in the Bible, but all the stories are telling one big story. The story of how God loves his children and comes to rescue them. It takes the whole Bible to tell this story. And at the center of this story, there is a baby. Every story in the Bible whispers his name. He is like the missing piece in a puzzle, the piece that makes all the other pieces fit together, and suddenly you can see a beautiful picture. And this is no ordinary baby. This is the child on whom everything would depend. It had taken centuries for God's people to be ready, but now the time had almost come for the best part of God's plan. God himself was going to come, not to punish his people, but to rescue them. God was getting ready to wipe away every tear from every eye, and the true party was just about to begin. Everything was ready. The moment God had been waiting for was here at last. God was coming to help his people, just as he promised in the beginning. But how would he come? What would he be like? What would he do? Mountains would have bowed down, seas would have roared, trees would have clapped their hands. But the earth held its breath. As silent as snow falling, he came in. And when no one was looking, in the darkness, he came.
You will call him Jesus.
He is God's only Son. He's the one. He's the rescuer. The God who flung planets into space and kept them whirling around and around. The God who made the universe with just one word. The one who could do anything at all was making himself small and coming down as a baby.
Oh, great and wondrous mystery. Christ.
Thank you.
Sure enough, it was just as the angel had said. 9 months later, Mary was almost ready to have her baby. Now, Mary and Joseph had to take a trip to Bethlehem, the town King David was from. But when they reached the little town, they found every room was full. Every bed was taken. Go away, the innkeepers told them. There isn't any place for you. Where would they stay? Soon Mary's baby would come. They couldn't find anywhere except an old, tumble-down stable. So they stayed with the cows and the donkeys and the horses. And there, in the stable, amongst the chickens and the donkeys and the cows, in the quiet of the night, God gave the world his wonderful gift. The baby that would change the world was born, his baby son. Mary and Joseph wrapped him up to keep him warm. They made a soft bed of straw and used the animal's feeding trough as its cradle. And they gazed in wonder at God's great gift, wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. Mary and Joseph named him Jesus, Emmanuel, which means God has come to live with us, because, of course, he had.
No.
Everyone and everyone. Today in David's town, in Bethlehem, God's Son hath been born. You can go and see him. He's sleeping in a manger. Behind the angel, they saw a strange, groaning cloud. Except it wasn't a cloud. It was angels. Troops and troops of angels armed with light, and they were singing a beautiful song. Glory to God, and to God in heaven and on earth and all our prayers.
Thank you.
Darker than I got, the brighter the star shines.